I am Ebony Evaughn. Welcome back to my channel. Today, you are in for a treat. I am back with another Ebony Explains to show you how you can actually redirect emails from a alias or from one G Suite Gmail account within your business workspace to another one. So why you may want to actually do this is, let's say you have multiple employees that have their own G Suite account within your business. Maybe you have different departments, so you have your own personal email. Like I have my Ebony email address for messages to come directly to me, but I also have one for customer support, for general customers, and then I have one for private VIP clients. I have one for collaborations as well. So we have different email addresses that are used for different things, but you may have an employee that is terminated. They no longer with the company, and you want to forward all the emails going to that inbox to a new employee or to a general email box. So I'm going to show you how you can actually do that in this video. So in order to set up a forward, the best way that I have found to do this is through setting up your email forwarding using the address mapping option. And so in order to do that, what you want to do is go to apps and then go down to Gmail, and then from here what you want to do is go down to routing. What's this grayed out? There we go. All right, go down to routing, and then once you go into routing, you'll notice there is a routing up here at the top, but you don't want to use that. Keep scrolling. If you scroll down to the bottom, you will see there is another option that says email forwarding. Let me highlight this so you can see, using recipient address map. This works best from my experience. So what you want to do is just go over and hit configure. And then in configure, you want to name the routing. And so what I'm actually doing is I'm setting up a forward. So I have a default customer support email address that's separate, independent from my own personal email for my business. And under that, I have an email alias for collaborations. So I'm going to name this collaboration inquiries. And so basically you want to just give your email forward a name so that you know what it is for. Typically I try to name my forward whatever it is. So for example, I'm going to be forwarding, I have an email alias collab@soulstruckrep.com that is specifically for business inquiries, sponsorship opportunities, and partnerships. And instead of that going to my generic customer support box, I actually want those collaboration inquiry emails to be forwarded to my personal Ebony email address. So you want to name your forward whatever it is that it's going to be doing, so you can kind of know what it is just by glancing. And it just goes with how I like to use a nomenclature for everything and any workflow that I have, which is a personal thing. But basically, you want to name your forward for what it is. And then the next thing that you want to do is you want to set up the actual forwarding map. So you'll see it say to forward emails, map original recipient to the new recipient. So in order to add a new one, I'm just going to click add. And then I'm going to add the email addresses. So I want to have my collab@soulstruckrep.com. And I want it to go to my personal inbox at soulstruckrep.com. And then I'm going to hit enter. And then once you have your email addresses, the email address that you want to be directed, where you want it to be directed to, the next thing that you want to do is just add a couple different features if they make sense for you. So the next thing is going to say messages to effect. And so you can decide if you want this to impact all incoming messages to that email address or only external. So If you do only external, this is going to be emails that are coming from outside of emails with your domain. So for example, if someone sends an email internally to collab@socialgrep.com and it's coming from, let's say, info@socialgrep.com, I don't need that email to necessarily come to me because it's internal and it's probably just kind of like a general notification or something internally to between myself or another team member or employee, right? So external only means if it's coming from outside of my domain. So any emails that come in that do not have an @socialgrep.com domain, those are the emails that I want to come to me. So I'm going to change this to only external. Depending on your workflow and why you're forwarding this one, you may want all incoming emails to go. But in my case, my scenario, I only want external incoming emails or messages to be forwarded to me. And then also you can set the routing option. If you want to have the email to also go to the original destination, then you could just check this box here. And so basically if you check this, this means that the email will not only be forwarded to you, but it will still be sent to the original destination as well. If you uncheck this box, then instead of sending the email to the original destination, collab@socialgrep.com, instead of going there, emails will be sent to @socialgrep.com. Okay. Now, I'm going to keep this checked because I do want it to go to both places. I want it to go to my general customer support box so that my assistant will see it, but I also want them to come to me as well. And so once you choose your criteria, you set up your email, all you have to do is hit save. And once you hit save, it will give you a confirmation to let you know that it is set up and you have your rules set. And so one thing to note is typically within minutes of doing this, you will notice that your forwarding will kick in and it will start to forward emails to your new destination. But in some cases, it can take up to 24 hours for this redirect to actually take place. But there you have it. This is a quick and easy tutorial on how to forward your Gmail email addresses from one email workspace or email alias to another account within the same workspace. Thank you guys so much for stopping by my internet home. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials just like this in the future. Bye, guys.